Hey guys, Dr. Prometheus here, back with some more of our Blue Jays franchise. We get Kenta Maeda out there. We going to see Frankie Montas on the mound for the White Sox. We have a 3-0 series win, a series lead, and this is an elimination game for the White Sox. It'll be a big one here if we can do it. Be against another right-hander, so it'll be our usual lineup that we've kind of went with. Crack into this one. Let's go. Let's go. For Kenta Maeda, is one start, no decision, a 1.80 ERA in five innings. Gave up four hits, had four strikeouts and one walk with a whip. Okay, we're gonna have to worry about this splitter. Yep, that's a good single there. Here we go, Frankie Montas. No decision in his last start. 5.40 ERA in five innings pitched, gave up five hits, two walks, and four strikeouts. Let's go.
Second, the shortstop, Javier Baez. Batting third, the second baseman, Jose Altuve.
One ball, two strikes. Ball. Two balls, two strikes.
Ooh, that is launched, and that's gone. Let's go. Altuve. All right.
Batting fifth, the designated hitter, Jesse Winker.
Ooh, that's a good one. All right, Jose Altuve gives us the lead to start it out. Let's go. Okay, Maeda. It has to be a controlling game. We have to get our pitches on the spot. Let's go. Let's go. All right, Bo.
Playing two balls, two strikes.
What a pitch.
The catcher, Kyle Schwarber.
Be easily.
Batting it, the left fielder, Cavan Biggo.
All right, Biggio batting 375. Yep, he's out. Mandrigal. What doesn't help is he does not have a hit in the playoffs. Wow. Okay, I did not see that happening, but the fact that one of their best players doesn't have a hit? Well, that's why they're about to get swept. Good snag.
up next to the Blue Jays, the center fielder, Trey Turner.
One ball, two strikes.
Is he 3-0 through now?
Now batting, shortstop, Javier Baez.
All right, let's see. Ooh, that's a nice pitch. A splitter, baby. Easy play for Altuve. There's Vlad. Okay.
Now that first baseman, Vladimir Guerrero Jr.
Come on, Vlad. Oh, I thought he caught it.
Now that, the designated hitter, Jesse Winker.
That's going to score a run.
The back, the third baseman. Go. His
next.
Don't want to swing at that. That's high, and we can't do anything with that. don't know what that was. Let's go. Come on, Schwarb. Outside? Come on, Beach. Inside? That's a great pitch there.
Up next for the Blue Jays, the right fielder, Victor Robles.
Come on, Robles. Not gonna give something to Robles here. Ooh.
Next to the White Sox, the second baseman, Nick Mangum.
All right.
Out.
Let's go. Let's go.
The batter number 9, shortstop, Javier.
Okay, they're going to take out Montas and go to Jimmy Lambert.
Now pitching for the White Sox, number 59, Jimmy Lambert.
Let's go. Baez runs that one out.
Now back, second baseman, Jose Altuve.
I rolled over it. We're not going to risk this. We're going to go straight to it. We're going to go Pochi. Kenta Maeda, pretty good game. Gives us the ability to work it out with the bullpen and win the game. Girardi has put himself together some good management team here. And hey, this is what we expected from this team. It was our time to do something. Especially with Urias, we bought in a couple big pieces, and now one of those pieces gets the opportunity for us to advance into the World Series. So here we go. The job is not done. Poche gets that first one. Let's go. Okay, so we're going to go Burrell. Inside. Come on, Winker. That should be easily playable. I think what we'll do is before the World Series, we'll see the awards. Kind of see that. Before the World Series, so. I know many of you might have said, hey, we need to do a awards episode. We'll get there. Now batting, catcher, Kyle. We will get there. But first, we got to get this one, baby. Ooh. Good contact, but the straight center, not gone.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. Now pitching for the team. Number 22, Jason Farrell.
Lane 12, one ball, two strikes.
Let's go. If this keeps on going, that means Mandrigal does not have a hit in the playoffs. Okay, we're going to bat first before we come out and try to end this game.
Up next for the Blue Jays, the center fielder, Trey Turner. Your attention, please. Now pitching for
Okay, Peralta. All right, two more outs. So we're into the World Series. Gonna let up a single here. Come on, we gotta get this Peralta. I don't know about that. And that's going to score the runner. Tie ball game now. Could not hold it.
Second baseman, Jose Altuve.
Altuve can just end this game right here. He doesn't want to pitch to me. He does not want to pitch to Altuve. Let's go, baby. Give me something. That's a walk. What? It would not allow me to turn him. What the hell happened there? That was weird. Bro, why are we in the infield like that? Why are we in? There's no reason to be in. That's not the game. Jeez! What is that? AIDS! Wow, that formation's so bad. If that formation was in, we were playing straight up, he's out at home. Come on, guys! It's like no one reacted to the ball when it was hit. I feel like this is, this is the Cubs in 2008. Just blowing, Moises Alou just blowing, not being able to catch the ball in the outfield. Just wow. And we go to another game. No part of him. Well, this game's done. We had a chance to win this and we blew it. Peralta blows his first save of the postseason. Because trying to actually get hits against Crochet or Crockett is so difficult. Even though that was a good. Or no, it was a good week. Never mind. Well, it means we have to do another game and Julio Urias is on the mound. Yeah, the 102 speed is just not going to happen. Well, we lost that because Peralta could not close out the game. At the end of the day, it's not the end of the world. It became nonsense when I was trying to go over with Cavan Biggio and I had my left stick all the way to the left and he was not running to the left. He was just running towards home, which was silly. Okay. Julio Urias. We're going to play this one here. We're going to be in our reds, our alternate twos. We need to win this. Still an elimination game. Julio Urias, who struggled in his second start. We expect him to come in and actually play better. Just, you have to play better. He's out. Get out of here. This is already starting bad. Yoman Kanda goes yard against Julio Urias because we can't keep the ball down. And then we walk Luis Robert. We cannot get this ball past him whatsoever. Come on, Urias. What? Make that play. I thought he had it. Okay. Going up against Raul Gonzalez. No starts in the playoffs. If we're going to make some damage here, we got to do something here. This is the game. And we're not going to win doing that. Come on, guys. Or me. There's no reason to reach for that. What are you doing? That was not a smart swing whatsoever. Baez batting 128 in a postseason is not helping matters. Batting third. The other side, Atlanta is up 3-2 over the Cardinals. A good pitch. Okay. Be smart. We gotta swing at that. I would have been fielded anyway. No business swinging at that again. Come on.
Batting sixth, the third baseman. SoL.
Two and two.
We gotta swing at that. Jeez, Urias, that's on the outside corner. Not that, wow. Madrigal has his first hit of the postseason. That is a good release, and it's literally almost an entire foot from where I'm aiming. Like, that's not even close, Urias. Okay, mound visit. Thank you. Not where I wanted it, but we get the call. That was a little dicey.
Batting it, the left fielder, Cavan Biggo.
I just missed that.
batting ninth, the right fielder, Victor Robles.
Dude, I'm just there. I need to get the PCI on it. We got home runs. Urias is struggling so much right now. This is not something we needed. Better get there. Be smart. We just missed that one too. We're going for two. Would have been a close play. Yeah, Altuve. You gotta just take that pitch. All right, that's it for the Urias, I think. 96. We'll go one more batter. Schwarber bailed you out. Okay, that's it.
That's the ball. Full count.
nothing, man. Just cannot get solid contact on the ball. But the fact that we're allowing Gonzalez to have this many, like this few pitches right now in the fifth inning is just unacceptable. Okay. Oh my gosh. Why? I didn't get all of that. Oh, I thought that was off the wall. You're teasing me, game. If we see Crochet at Crockett, we won't be able to score on that. Wow, Tuve just... That's good contact. And we still can't get a hit. Just missed that. We're going to send him home. It's probably inadvisable. Luckily, the throw's off the mark. Okay.
shortstop.
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Now pitching for the White Sox, number 48, Jeffrey Passantino. Now batting, the left fielder, Cavan Biggo.
1-2, the count.
Wow. We gotta take that pitch.
The right fielder, number 60, Victor Robles.
I don't like that pitch. Wow, I missed time, aimed everything. Wow.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the number 38.
No, that missed. That's the ball.
All right, Robles. Let's go. I didn't mean to swing there. You're not swinging at that garbage.
The batter number 9. Shortstop, Javier Baez.
That missed. That's the ball.
All right, Baez. Now it comes to Altuve.
Baseman, Altuve.
Don't like that pitch. That would have been a home run if I would have got the PCI on it. This is a guy we should be wrecking right now. Let's go. Perfect four seam. Okay. Good contact, but I think we just missed it with the PCI there. Yeah. You gotta take that pitch. That's likely a ball. Wait, who they got in the bullpen? Who is that? Oh, God. Again. We're gonna come out with Crochet next inning, I'm sure. Take a seat. Got him. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention. Okay, it's Kopech. Okay. We go Pharrell to put in the game. Oh, what a fantastic pitch.
Leading up for Toronto, the right fielder, Victor Robles.
number seven, Trey Turner. The batter number nine, shortstop, Javier Baez.
Should have been a pitch that we never threw. We're going to have Pharrell come in. Let's go. It's a big pitch. What a great snag by Bo. All right, Altuve. That's a strike.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Jesse Winker.
Okay, more extra inning baseball for you guys. Oh, God. And that is probably our game because they're going to bring in Crochet or Crochet, and we cannot. I can't hit him. Guys, we're going to go back to Chicago.
He's out of there.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for Chicago, number 45. Garrett Rochelle, a defensive change for the White Sox. Now playing first base, number 21, Zach Collins.
That 102 mile an hour fastball is ridiculous. Super focused mode right now. I got lucky. I even hit that. Yep. There it is. I was waiting for a fastball that was going to be down. There was no way in hell it was going to catch up to that. That was dumb. That was a dumb pitch to go after. He made another full count. That's so close, and that fastball is so fast, I can't make that hit. That hurts. Couldn't hit, man. We're going back to Alec Manoah, and I think at this point we go back to Chicago for two games. I mean, we just have to win one game. And I feel like this is 100%. It's not the 2008 or the 2012. It's the 2014 Cubs, I think it was. Just, what can you do? You just got to play better. That's what it comes down to. You got to finish, and you got to play better. Urias has struggled, but only one run. I was actually surprised by that. And then, who is it? Contreras gets that RBI. Come on, that's got to be much better there. But here we go. In the next episode, it's Alec Manoah. Our best, arguably what is our best pitcher this offseason. Looking at what it looks like on the other side, Atlanta beat the Cardinals, so Atlanta is waiting to see who comes to play. So, thanks for hanging out, guys. Don't forget to leave a like below, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys next time. Later.